behalf of the Paul Motorcycle Club, another concerned bikers in this area, about the initiation of the noise laws that are being established now, and that the police are randomly and indiscriminately, I guess, issuing tickets to people that they say are too loud in their exhaust, primarily being interested in the motorcycle. We've had a number of cases, several just tonight, where one person was ticketed, given a warning ticket, and the person sitting right beside him equally equipped motorcycle, nothing was said. The criteria for this ticket, we do not have even a vague understanding about what it is. We don't know what the law is that is covering this, other than peace disturbance. And I would argue with you that we are not disturbing peace. We are operating our equipment in a sensible and lawful way. A two-cylinder engine or even a four-cylinder engine is going to make more noise than a V8. The equipment that we put on our bikes is equipment that is legal to run on any road in the United States of America. Have laws and ordinances on the books right now that if an individual chooses to break the law, he has the right to go get it. I don't see where we need to do all this enhanced patrolling that we're doing right now. We, as a community in a whole, try to police ourselves, and I think we do a reasonably well job of it. I'm sure that somebody living on Broadway is going to hear more exhaust notes during the course of their day than somebody living up on Country Club. That's the facts of life. You live in a downtown metropolitan area, you've got to expect that you're going to pick up more noise there than someone living out in the burbs. If this is to continue on, and I'm hoping the council can halt to it, but if it should have to continue on, we need some more clarification on what we can be expected or what we will have to do in order to comply with the law. So far tonight, I've seen one complaint with equipment failure. Another one was improper operation of the equipment. One fellow that received a ticket here not too long ago, his motorcycle was parked. I assume since it was parked, not running, but it looked like it would be illegal, that better guidelines than this need to be published for the public consumption. With some exceptions, I would assume the equipment that we buy is described as legal equipment. And the ordinance the man talked on was this other device. A baffle pipe is another device. Is it as quiet as he may want to be? No. But is it within the federal guidelines and or probably the state guidelines as to what noise can be emitted at a prescribed distance? I say that they are. If you choose not to operate it that way, I'm quite sure you can do that also. But we have reached a point now with all the men that were down here and ladies that were down here tonight. A lot of them come by vehicle because they didn't know whether they didn't want to get a ticket, didn't know whether they would get a ticket. There's very few people in this room that I can see right now that can afford a $130-$150 fine. But yet they stand a chance of being arrested or ticketed without knowing anything about it. I guess.
Good evening, Council. My name is Chris O'Leary. I am an owner and operator of Hilltop Cycles here in town. I'm also an active motorcycle enthusiast. I'm here this evening asking for guidance interpreting City Ordinance 16-166 that states no person shall disturb Reading of others by discharge to the open air of this office against steam engine stationary in front of combustion engine motorboat or motor vehicle except through a buffer or other device that will effectively prevent loud or explosive noises therefrom. The first part of this ordinance is well defined. My question refers to the second part of this ordinance that states except through a buffer or other device. I brought with me a catalog, which is Parts Unlimited. It's probably the biggest dealers in the country for parts, you know, aftermarket parts, which offers multiple styles of bufflers that use various components, such as resonators, baffles, and silencers. All of these examples will pass Missouri State inspection. Would the examples in this book meet the city's definition of a buffer or other device? If your answer is yes, then you know I'm asking why are things being issued if we aren't in compliance. You know, if no, you know, I guess the remainder of the ordinance states that we don't effectively prevent loud or explosive noises therefrom, as it is currently written, has no quantifiable in its opinion based. As a business owner and enthusiast, how do I verify and advise others in selecting these exhaust systems that are compliant to this ordinance? Some of these exhaust systems can and have cost fellow enthusiasts in excess of $700 to $800. These systems cannot be returned once installed on your motorcycle. And as you can see by the examples in the book, which you're welcome to look in the book, that there is no information available to indicate the noise level that the item will deliver. This will also vary from bike to bike. So in summary, on behalf of my customers, my fellow enthusiasts, it's requested the city stop issuing tickets until a specific guideline is written that we may verify that we are in compliance of the ordinance. And I'd also like to add, too, that, you know, all these people in this room, we've done several donations, one for the city police department. We've done poker runs for Avenues for Women. We've done poker runs for newspapers for education. So I don't think everybody in this room is bad because we ride a motorcycle.
I don't think anyone in this room is saying any of
that. And, you know, I mean, a lot of my people feel like they're being targeted, you know. And